Good morning students. So today we solve some more problems on derivative of arc length. So here the problem is find ds by dx for the curve y square is equal to 4ax. Okay, so this y square is equal to 4ax is nothing but the parabola. So for this curve, we have to find a derivative of arc length. So for this, we apply the formula. First, we find dy by dx. So solution. So what is given? Write that y square is equal to 4ax. So now differentiating with respect to x, then it gives 2y dy by dx is equal to 4a. Okay, or in other words, dy by dx is equal to this 2 will get cancelled, then 2a by y, 2 1s are 2 2s are, so dy by dx is equal to 2a by y you will get. So therefore, now we apply the formula for derivative of arc length. So derivative of arc length is equal to what? Ds by dx. Okay, so this ds by dx is given by the formula ds by dx is equal to square root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square. Okay, so now already we found dy by dx, correct? So now call this equation as 1. Now substituting dy by dx from 1 in, call this equation as 2 in equation 2. Okay, so we get ds by dx is equal to square root of 1 plus dy by dx is 2a by y, whole square, which is equal to simplify, so you will get 1 plus 4a square by y square. You square it, then take the LCM, this is 1, so which is equal to ds by dx is square root of, on taking LCM, this is y square, then this becomes y square plus 4a square, or which is equal to square root of, now this y square, from this equation y square is equal to 4ax, correct? This is, so y square is equal to 4ax. Now substitute this value in this equation, where? In this and here. So what we obtain? Y square is equal to 4ax plus 4a square divided by y square is 4ax. On simplifying, we get ds by dx is equal to, here 4, taking 4a common, from the numerator, so it gives 2 root a into square root of x plus a, okay, divided by 2 root a. In the denominator also we take 4a common, since it is under square root, so therefore it gives, when it comes outside the square root, it is 2 root a, then root x. So this 2 root a, 2 root a get cancelled. Or this is equal to x plus a, root of x plus a divided by x. So this is the derivative of r plus. This is known as the derivative of r plus. So this is how we find the derivative of r plus. Okay. In the same way, we solve another problem. In the same way, we solve another problem. Second one, that is for the curve y is equal to a log sec x by a. Sec x by a, prove that ds by dx is equal to sec x by a, then ds by dy is equal to cosec x by a, then x is equal to a psi, and also prove that d square x by ds square is equal to 1 divided by 2a sine of 2x by a. Okay. So this is the given problem. So one curve is given. So this is the curve. Y is equal to a log sec x by a. And for this curve, we have to prove that ds by dx is equal to this much, and ds by dy is equal to this. Then x is equal to a psi. And also we have to show that this d square x by ds square is equal to 1 by 2a sine 2x by a. Okay. So this, now to solve this, what is given? You just write. So y is equal to a log sec x by a, it is given. Okay. So now differentiating with respect to x. Which gives dy by dx is equal to a is constant. You write a as it is. Then differentiation of log sec x by a. So differentiation of log sec x by a is 1 by sec x by a. Then again, applying chain rule, differentiation of sec x by a, it is sec x by a into tan x by a, because differentiation of secant theta into tan theta. Okay, so first we differentiate log sec x, so which is 1 by sec x by a, because log x differentiation is 1 by x. Then differentiation of sec x by a into tan x by a. Again we apply chain rule and we differentiate x by a. So x by a differentiation with respect to x is 1 by a. Okay, so in this sec x by a, then this a and a get cancelled. So therefore what we obtain, dy by dx is equal to tan x by a. Dy by dx is equal to tan x by a. Okay, so after finding dy by dx, next is to find ds by dx. So therefore ds by dx is equal to, apply the formula, dx by dx is 1 plus dy by dx whole square, which is equal to square root of 1 plus dy by dx means tan x by a whole square. Okay, or ds by dx is equal to, now this is 1 plus tan square theta. So 1 plus tan square theta means sec square theta. So this is square root of sec square x by a, which is equal to sec x by a. Okay, sec x by a. So thus we obtain ds by dx is equal to sec x by a. So first one we prove. So this one is done, right? Next we find ds by dy. We find ds by dy. So what we do to find ds by dy? We apply the formula. Ds by dy is equal to, therefore, ds by dy is equal to ds by dy is equal to apply the formula 1 plus square root of 1 plus dx by dy whole square, dx by dy whole square. Okay, now we have to find dx by dy. So no need to find dx by dy because we found dy by dx, we found dy by dx. Just reverse this. So means when you reverse dy by dx, it gives dx by dy. Okay, so when you reverse this, this one is also reversed, right? So means this is of the form tan x by a divided by 1. So when you reverse this, 1 divided by tan x by a. So 1 by tan theta is cot theta, right? 1 by tan theta is cot theta, so which is cot x by a, which is cot x by a, right? So now substitute this dx by dy here in this equation, so which gives 1 plus dx by dy means cot x by a, cot x by a whole square, that is cot square. So or ds by dy is equal to what is 1 plus cot square theta? 1 plus cot square theta is cosec square theta. So this is square root of cosec square theta, or square root of cosec square theta is cosec theta. Sorry, cosec x by a. Cosec x by a. Here cosec x by a. Here we have x by a. So here we should have x by a only. So x by a. So this is ds by dy. So therefore, second one is also, now second one is over. Next we have to show that x is equal to a psi. We have to show that x is equal to a psi. To find x is equal to a psi, so what we do? Now we know that already we found dy by dx. Dy by dx is equal to what? Tan x by a. This already we found. And but from the geometry, okay, from the geometry, dy by dx is nothing but slope of the tangent. Dy by dx is nothing but slope of the tangent, and this slope of the tangent is denoted by tan psi. So dy by dx is equal to tan psi, we know. Now substitute this value here. So now substituting dy by dx, okay, call this equation as not any given equation. So this is equation 1. So in 1 we get tan psi is equal to tan x by a. Tan psi is equal to tan x by a. Substitute this value of dy by dx in this equation 1. So here we have to substitute. So tan psi is equal to this tan x by a. So both sides tan will get cancelled and we will get psi is equal to, this implies psi is equal to x by a, or which implies on cross multiplication x is equal to a psi. X is equal to a psi. So this is third one is over. Okay, so this one, that is now this one is over. Now you have to prove this one. You have to prove this one. To prove this one, what we do? Ds square x by d square x by ds square it is. So now already we have found dx by ds. Already we have found dx by ds or ds by dx. So reverse this, you will get dx by ds, and this is also to be reversed. So 1 by sec x by a. So 1 by sec means it is cos. So then differentiating again with respect to x, correct? So the same way we will do this. Okay, so now to prove the next one, what we have? We have ds by dx is equal to sec x by a. Okay, so now when reverse this, we will get dx by ds. Okay, reversing dx by ds, this is also reversed, 1 by sec x by a. So 1 by sec x by a is cos x by a. So dx by ds is cos x by a. So now differentiating with respect to s, okay, we are differentiating with respect to s. So this gives d square x by ds square is equal to, now we differentiate first this cos x by a, so its differentiation is minus sin x by a, okay, minus sin x by a into, but again differentiation of x by a with respect to s. So 1 by a is constant. Now differentiation of x with respect to x, s is dx by ds, okay, or d square x by ds square is equal to, so minus 1 by a, this is sin x by a, okay. Then dx by ds, already we found this dx by ds is equal to what? Cos x by a. So this we have to substitute here, cos x by a, okay, cos x by a. So which is equal to, or d square x by ds square is equal to minus 1 by a. Now divide this by divide and multiply by 2. Divide and multiply by 2. So both numerator and denominator. So it gives 2 sin x by a cos x by a, and we divide this, right? So that is d square x by ds square is equal to, now this is 1 by 2a. Now what is 2 sin a cos a? Sin 2a, sin 2x by a, sin 2x by a. Okay, so this is the third one we proved now. So that is, the third one is minus 1 by 2a, okay, minus 1 by 2a, minus 1 by 2a sin of x 2x by a. So this is also we have solved. Okay, so this is how we solve the problems on finding the derivative of arc length. So with this, I conclude this class and continue in the नेक्स्ट सेशन. थैंक यू.